racket robs me of my rest. Love, hopeless love, my heart and soul encumbers. Love, nightmare-like, lies heavy on my chest. And weaves itself into my midnight slumbers. The dismal headache and reposes tabooed by anxiety. I conceive you may use any language you choose to indulge in without impropriety. For your brain is on fire, the bedclothes conspire of usual slumber to plunder you. First your counterpane goes and uncovers your toes, and your sheet slips demurely from under you. The blanketing tickles you feel like makes pickles so terribly sharp is the pricking. And you're hot and you're cross and you tumble and toss till there's nothing twixt you and the ticking. Then the bedclothes all creep to the ground in a heap and you pick them all up in a tangle. Next your pillow resigns and politely declines to be blamed in its usual angle. Well, you guess I'm reposing in the form of a doze with hot eyeballs and head ever aching. But your slumbering teems are such horrible dreams that you'd very much better be waking. For you dream you are crossing the channel and tossing about in a steamer from Harwich, which is something between a large bathing machine and a very small second-class carriage. And you're giving a treat, many ice and cold meat, to a party of friends and relations. They're a ravenous horde and they all came on board at Sloane Square and South Kensington stations. And bound on that journey you find your attorney who started that morning from Devon. He's a bit undersized and you don't feel surprised when he tells you he's only 11. Well, you're driving like mad with a singular lad by the by, the ship's now four-wheeler, and you're playing round games and he calls you bad names and you tell him the ties pay the dealer. Well, this you can't stand, so you throw up your hand and you find you're as cold as an icicle. Your shirt and your socks with black silk with gold cross, cause he saw Salisbury Plain on a bicycle. And he and the crew are on bicycles too, which they somehow or other invested in. And he's telling the tars all the particulars of a company he's interested in. It's a scheme of devices to get at low prices all goods who've got mixtures to cables, which tickled the sailors by treating retailers as though they were all vegetables. You get a good spaceman to plant a small trade and for take off his boots with a boot tree, and his legs will take root and his fingers will shoot. They'll blossom and bud like a fruit tree. From the green grocery tree you get grapes and green pea, cauliflower, pineapples and cranberries, while the pastry cook plant cherry brandy will grant apple puffs and three corners and mandaries. The shares are a penny and ever so many are taken by Rothschild and Baring, and just as a few were allotted to you, you awake the shallow despair. You're a regular record of clicking your neck and no wonder you snore, for your head's on the floor and your needles and pins from your soles to your shins. Your flesh is a green for your left legs asleep. There's a crab in your toes and a fly in your nose, some plump in your lung and a feverish tongue and a thirst of intent in a general sense. You haven't been sleeping in clover, but the darkness has passed and it's daylight at last, and the night has been long. Ditto, ditto, my song. And thank God.